Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. In this video, we will see the difference between customized posts and prefabricated posts, and also the stepwise protocol that should be followed for the fabrication of the entire post and core restoration. This is the continuation of the part one of the video. If you haven't watched the part one, I would recommend you to watch that to get a better understanding of the factors influencing the success of post and core procedure, and then come back to this video. The reason why post and core is extremely important is because you can save so many natural teeth, and if you don't have the knowledge of this procedure, you would probably end up extracting a perfectly healthy tooth. For example, even a root piece can be restored with this procedure. And however great implants are, there is nothing better than having a natural tooth in place. So moving on, let us take a look at the different types of post systems that are available. They're essentially classified into two. One is customized post and the other is prefabricated post. Customized posts are also popularly known as cast posts. So these are custom made posts and are fabricated with the help of a lab, and the coronal portion or the core is attached to the post as one unit. They can be fabricated in different types of metal or ceramic. The other type that we have are the prefabricated posts. These involve placing the post and core restoration in one visit. These posts come in several forms. They can be parallel, tapered, smooth, serrated, active, passive. All this has already been covered in part 1. The link is in the description box in case you haven't watched it already. These prefabricated posts are also available in different materials like stainless steel, titanium, composite, and fiber posts. Fiber reinforced post systems are the most popular and are most commonly used because of the numerous advantages that it has. We will be coming to that in some time. First, we will take a look at the customized posts. As the name suggests, these posts are custom fabricated to fit the root canal anatomy. The advantages are, it conserves the root structure as it does not require removal of additional root dentine as in the case of prefabricated posts. The second advantage is that the core is a part of the assembly, and therefore these posts have no weak interface between them. The fact that post and core is one piece ensures that the core cannot break away from the post. Customized posts are also closely adapted to the root dentine. Even in case of wide canals, these posts also have high strength and work well in the posteriors under heavy masticatory forces. Coming to the disadvantages, these posts are generally cast in alloy, and therefore they have a modulus of elasticity which is 10 times that of dentine. Because of this, it transfers the functional stresses on the dentine, which can ultimately result in endodontic or restorative failure. Also, the entire technique takes a longer chairside time and have to be completed in multiple appointments. Even chairside temporization is very difficult in these cases. So if a patient wants an immediate restoration, it may be a little difficult with a customized post. These are also technique sensitive and are lab dependent, which may result in inaccuracies. Some cases where customized posts work better than prefabricated ones are large diameter or oval canals where the prefabricated posts tend to fit loose. Since these are customized, the post fits intimately into the canal space even if the canal is not round. It works well in small teeth like mandibular anteriors, where there is less than ideal coronal tooth structure available to retain the core buildup. Custom-made posts can also be used when a tooth is malaligned. In these cases, the core is angled in relation to the post to achieve proper alignment with the adjacent teeth. Another great use of customized posts are when multiple teeth are involved. It is much easier and faster to make an impression and get the post fabricated in the lab instead of an individual buildup. Coming to the prefabricated posts, these posts are cemented or screwed in the root space. The small core that protrudes from the root is packed with dental composite material. After the material has been cured and adjusted, an impression is taken for the fabrication of the prosthetic crown. This is a direct chairside procedure and is more popularly used. Let us take a look at the advantages. Prefabricated posts do not require multiple appointments. It can be done on the same day. Multiple material and design options are available. There is no lab involvement. It is also easy to temporize a tooth. All these advantages makes it extremely convenient to use. Coming to the disadvantages, since prefabricated posts are circular in cross section, they do not provide any anti-rotation feature. For a prefabricated post, the route is modified to accept the post rather than the post being customized to fit the route space. And also, they often require removal of sound root dentine to ensure proper fit and retention of the post. The metal prefabricated post systems, which were very commonly used earlier, are now gradually being replaced by fiber-reinforced composite resin post systems. Why have these newer fiber-reinforced post systems become so popular and almost replaced the use of prefabricated metal posts? There are numerous reasons for this. The fiber post system preserves the tooth structure and are non-corroding. They have similar modulus of elasticity as that of dentine, decreasing the chances of root fracture and making them more compatible than their metal counterparts. The fiber post can be bonded instead of regular cementation, and that increases the retention. Apart from that, they are safer, more easily removed, and aesthetic. And now we will discuss the steps involved in the entire process of post and coat. We'll see the procedure for both customized post and prefabricated fiber post. First, let us start with the steps common to both. So the first thing to do is evaluate clinically and radiographically if the tooth is suitable for post and coat. Make sure that the tooth is not periodontally compromised, infected or inflamed. Also check for any irregularities in the root configuration with an X-ray. The second step is to remove any existing restoration, caries, thin or unsupported walls of the tooth structure. But remember, you have to preserve as much coronal tooth structure as possible to enable the axial walls of the crown to externally brace the tooth. That is for a proper ferrule effect. At least 1.5 to 2 mm of tooth structure should be present above the gingival margin. If that is not present, you may have to do an orthodontic extrusion or crown lengthening procedure. For a custom post, you need to first prepare the coronal portion of the tooth for a ferrule. So make sure that you have a circumferential ferrule of 1.5 to 2 mm height and 1 to 2 mm width. For a fiber post, it is okay if you don't create the ferrule initially. It can be done after the post cementation. The third step is to calculate the length of the post space that you have to create. This can be done in two ways. If you have performed the root canal procedure for the tooth, then it becomes very easy for you because you probably know the working length already. All you have to do is subtract 5 mm from the total working length. The working length minus 5 mm will give you the post length. But remember one very important thing. When doing this, you have to make sure that the reference point that was originally taken for the working length while performing the root canal is the same. And in case you have shaved down the original reference point for a ferrule, you will have to modify the working length accordingly. Another way to calculate your post length is through a radiograph. So you can take an RVG or an IOPA, determine the length of the obturated canal and subtract 5 mm from the length. The issue with this is that your RVG may not always give you the correct working length because of elongation or shortening in the X-ray. So I personally don't rely on it entirely. To be safe, you can consider the average length of a root. For example, if it is a central incisor, the average length of the root is 13 mm, and consider you have 2 to 3 mm of coronal portion. So you can consider your working length to be 15 mm and your post length will be 15 minus 5, that is 10 mm. It is okay if it is short. You can always take an RVG after you create the post space and judge if you need to increase the length. But if you over prepare, you cannot reverse that. So it's better to be safe than sorry. Now, coming to the fourth point, once the length is determined, you will start creating the post space or the channel within the obturated tooth. How will you do that? There are essentially two ways to do that. One is using drills like piezo reamers and Gates Glidden drill. These drills are generally quite safe and chances of you perforating the canal is also minimized as these have non-cutting tips. You can put a stopper on these drills according to the post length that you have already determined, and the drill has to be just a size smaller than the canal space. If you have any doubts on which diameter drill to choose, then start with number one drill in the sequence and then go on till all the gutta percha from the canal wall is removed. Do not over prepare the post space as you will weaken the tooth. I've explained all the important points to remember for a post and core in part one. So again, I would recommend you to watch that video first and then come to this one. The second method to create your post space is by using a heated plugger. But you have to be extremely careful with these because you may end up pulling out the entire GP. To prevent that from happening, you need to make sure that you use a red hot plugger. insert it in the pore space, brush it against the dentinal wall, and quickly withdraw it. You can remove the GP with this technique. It is better to use a piezoreamer in the canal after the GP is removed, just to make sure that there are no undercuts or irregularities in the canal. One more point that I would like to mention is that if the root canal is really old and the obturated material has lost its thermoplasticity, or you're facing a lot of resistance to create a pore space with your drills, you can use a GP solvent to soften the GP followed by the drills. Enlarge the canal sufficiently with your drills. You basically have to make sure that there is no gutta percha remaining on the walls. Don't enlarge beyond that and confirm with an X-ray. Once the pore space is created, irrigate the channel with distilled water or normal saline to remove all the debris and dry the canal completely. You can air dry it and also use paper points. So now that you are done with your pore space preparation, these steps remain pretty much the same for any pore system you are using. From here on, we'll move two separate ways. The remaining steps to be followed for a customized or cast pore system and for a fiber pore system. Just a reminder, if you feel that this video has helped you in any way, please do hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. It means a lot to me. So first we'll discuss the custom or cast pore system. Actually, if you think about it, it is more of customized pore system, because these days with all the technological and material advancements, you don't always have to go through a casting procedure really. So customized pores will be more appropriate. Okay then. So you've removed the GP, created the pore space, cleaned and dried it. To fabricate your final customized pores, you can do it in two ways. One is a direct method and the other is an indirect method. In the direct method, a cast pore pattern is made chair side and then it is sent to the lab for fabrication of the final customized pore. In the indirect technique, an impression is made of the pore space and then it is sent to the lab. The pore pattern is made on the stone model and then it is processed. Indirect technique works really well when you have multiple teeth involved. We'll see the steps involved in fabrication of the pore pattern by direct method. First, if you have a circular canal, it is better to place an anti-rotational groove on the thickest part of the orifice of the canal. After that, you have to lubricate the canal and the remaining tooth structure with a petroleum jelly. You can then use a plastic sprue as a base for the customized pore pattern, like the pin jet from Angelus. Check the fit of the plastic sprue in the canal space. It should fit loosely. Next, you need to take a self-cure resin. I like pattern resin from GC as it is easy to use, fast setting and has better dimensional accuracy. So the polymer and the monomer of your self-cure resin are mixed together, and when it reaches the dough stage, you need to apply the resin on your plastic post. Then this moldable resin is introduced in the post space. Make sure that the coronal portion of the tooth is also covered with the resin. As the material polymerizes, the post is pumped in and out of the canal to prevent interlocking. Do not let the resin harden completely inside the canal, as it will make its retrieval very difficult. You can add more pattern resin if you feel that the pore space has not been captured correctly or if there are any voids or inaccuracies in the pore pattern. After all this is done, make sure that the pattern fits properly in the pore space. There are no gaps between the core part and the incisal edge of the tooth. Otherwise, you will have to repeat the whole process. Once the pattern is prepared and checked for its fit and accuracy, all you have to do is now prepare the core part. Remove all the excess material with a burr such that your final core resembles a tooth preparation. Then this is sent to the lab for further processing. Coming to the indirect method, similar to the direct method, you will first do the preparation for the coronal part of the ferrule and prepare the pore space. Lubricate the pore space, insert the plastic sprue or an orthodontic wire, check that it fits loosely in the canal space, remove the plastic sprue and apply your polyvinyl siloxane tray adhesive on the plastic sprue or the orthodontic wire that you're using. Once that is done, fill the canal space with your polyvinyl siloxane impression material completely, basically your light body material. Then insert your sprue or the orthodontic wire and take a pickup impression. Check for voids and inaccuracies, and then your part is now done. The impression is sent to the lab and the lab technician fabricates a post pattern on the stone model, which is then converted to the final post Moving on, we will now discuss the steps involved for a fiber post and core technique. So when it comes to a fiber post, you need to first understand the post system that you're using. Almost all companies have similar protocols. You have posts of different sizes. They generally come in three different sizes, which are color-coded. And these sizes will have a corresponding drill. So you can create your post space with the drills that are provided. Let us understand this easily with an example. So we'll consider the post system from 3M, the RelyX fiber post. This system has three posts of different sizes, the yellow, red, and blue, and they have their corresponding drills. After the primary access with a piezo reamer or a gauge slit and drill, you can prepare the post space starting with the size number one post drill or the yellow one, keeping the stopper at the predetermined post length. After you create the post space, the corresponding post will go into the canal space. Then take an X-ray, check for the fit of the post, and make sure that there is no GP remaining on the walls. For larger canals, you may need to go to drill number 2 or 3. All that depends on the case in front of you. Now, there are some systems like the Refor Post by Angelus. This system also has three sizes and are all color-coded, but they are not provided with any corresponding drill. It does, however, correspond to the piezo reamers that are universally available. So, it is very important to read the manual of the post system that you're using very carefully. It is no rocket science. Everything is clearly mentioned in the manuals. I think we all need to make it a habit to read manuals and catalogs of all the materials that we use. So I hope you guys have understood that. If you have any doubts, as always, you can mention them in the comment section or you can email your queries to me. Always happy to answer your questions. So continuing further, a post space is created. We check the fit of the post, irrigate the canal, dried it out completely. Also put a mark on the post with a pencil or an indelible pen for your reference. The next step is cementation or bonding of the post. You can use GIC or RMGIC, but it is preferable to use resin cement for bonding because of its many advantages. To know more about that, you can check out the part 1 of the video. So for that, first you have to completely etch the post space that is created and also the remaining tool structure with 37% phosphoric acid. Wash the etching out, dry the canal. Next, apply the bonding agent on the dentinal walls of the canal and on the coronal tool structure with a thin micro brush. Air dry the bonding agent and blot out any excess bonding agent with a paper point. You can then cure the bonding agent. Then you can apply silane coupling agent to the post to improve the bond strength. And finally, fill the canal space with the resin cement. Use a self-cure or a dual-cure resin cement for post and core as the light may not pass through the post. Insert the post in the canal, make sure that your reference point that you had marked is at the right position and let the resin cement set completely. Once the cement sets, shear off the excess post with the burr. This is then followed by a core buildup around the post with composite, followed by tooth preparation and impression for the final prosthesis. And with this, we come to an end. I know it was a little long, but I wanted to explain every tiny detail for your understanding. Stay tuned for a video tutorial that I will be uploading of this post and core process, both for customized as well as prefabricated. And if you feel that this video has benefited you in any way, please don't forget to hit the like, share, and subscribe button.